Hey, it's time for trash talk again, every Tuesday. Week. We do this every week.
Every week.
Yeah, we keep punishing ourselves. Yep. And we hope we're punishing you too, because we're thankful that you're here with us every week and tuning in and checking out Trash Talk, because we enjoy doing this and it's a lot of fun for us. And it also is a great way for us to tell you about the Patriot Sandwich Company in Denton, Texas. Great sandwich shop. Nothing compares to it. And I mean, I'm being perfectly honest, right? I mean, nobody makes sandwiches like David Jordan and his staff.
No, they don't. Look, just because they sponsor us doesn't mean we have to like them, but we like them. Like,
that's right.
They're good people. They're great people. It's a great cause. It's local. It's veteran owned. I mean, everything that David does is about giving back, not just to the community, but to, you know, but to his fellow veterans. He just gives back. I mean, everything he does is focused on reciprocation, and it's really been a great asset to the city of Denton and really all around us. So very excited. If you haven't been down there, the Patriot Sandwich Company, we highly suggest you do it. Go online, get directions, Google, ask Siri, whatever you got to do, and get on down there, check them out.
Yeah. And as Brandon said, go online. You can see samples of some of the sandwiches. The bread is fresh. The meats are freshly sliced. All the condiments that they put on the sandwiches, everything is fresh. It's not prepackaged and refrigerated. It's all fresh every day. David insists on that. And because of that, that's why we want him to be our sponsor. And we love him, and we love what he's doing for our veterans too. So Patriot Sandwich Company, get down there and see him.
Absolutely.
And you know what? We thought we'd talk a little bit about movies. There's nothing better than to have a Patriot Sandwich Company sandwich with the chips, with the drink, which, by the way, is free if you mention Trash Talk.
That's right.
Bring it home, sit down, watch the movies, you know, especially, you know, can you believe that they got the Academy Awards scheduled for next month?
You know what? I was going to bring that up to you. They got the award. So they've got the Academy Awards for what? There was like three movies that came out and made it to the movie theater. The rest have been streaming or postponed. I mean, all the big ones have been delayed. James Bond, Black Widow, all those have been delayed. Or, when we'll get to that in a minute, they're now going to streaming. So what are you going to give an award for? Like, for what, you know?
Yeah, I mean, you know, how can you get the pulse of the public? Because they didn't go in the theaters and sit and watch the movies. You know how they always rate them? They have the critics ratings and then the people's ratings, and the critics give it, you know, 65%, and the people give it either 40% or 80%. How do they base what the public is watching now?
And that's the thing, like, so half the movies haven't come out, half didn't get to the homes that they were supposed to, or the viewership. And this is why, you know what, the Oscars, I don't like, I miss the days. Ricky Gervais, one of the greatest, funniest dudes ever.
Yep.
He hosted it, what was it, last year? And it was
because
the year before,
because of COVID. Yeah. Ago. So this is the second year that it's weak.
So when he hosted it, and he hosted it for 4 years, but it was his final year, he blasted Hollywood. He trashed probably the greatest thing I've ever seen. But he's got a point. Really, all they're going to do is get a bunch of overpaid actors out there to talk about the world, make it green, support Joe Biden, don't do this. And it's just It's just an ego thing, man. It's not about the movies this year.
Yeah, it's, you know, and always like that, the, well, just to be nominated is you know, award in itself. Whether
no,
I win
not.
Or not, it doesn't matter. To hell it doesn't matter.
Of course it matters. You know. Look, if you win an Oscar, you're guaranteed a next movie. If you don't win an Oscar, nobody's going to remember your name tomorrow, 9 times out of 10.
Yes. Yeah. ask your friends, who was the runner up to last year's, Oscar winner for best actor? Number one, you can't even probably remember who won the best actor last year, let alone right. who the other people that were nominated.
And it doesn't always go to the best either. That's the thing. And I know that could be just my opinion, but when the vast majority of the people, even in Hollywood, are like, look how long it took Leonardo DiCaprio to win. I mean, one of the best actors out there.
Yeah.
And they basically just gave it to him because they knew they needed to. And that happened with Denzel Washington too. Denzel is one of the greatest actors out there. He deserves it for so many different movies. And they finally gave it to him. And I know he's a very humble guy. He's a great guy. So he doesn't care. But I'm sitting there watching it going, you gave it to Jim Bob, who hasn't been in another movie, but you passed up Denzel?
Yeah. Unfortunately, I don't really think that the Academy Awards are picked by the people. It's all the people in the industry. So, you know, there's a lot of under the table politics going on there. You know, the People's Choice Awards, that one it appeals to me even more because it's the people that have voted for those. Even the Golden Globes, because those are the critics that are the ones that select. But the Academy Awards is just a big popularity contest. And the red carpet is what it's really all about, to see who's wearing whose designer label.
It's going to be designer masks this year.
Yes. And whose mask are you wearing tonight?
Yes, it looks like Benicio del Toro is wearing something from Gucci.
Wearing Oleg Cassini.
Look at this. Steve Carell's got Armani on his mask, you know.
Yes, you know, and here comes Angelina Jolie wearing Valentino with the studs.
Well, she probably got a mask from South Africa made by some kid in a hut just to support, you know, her cause.
Yeah.
Even though she flew in on a private airplane.
Yeah. That would be a good thing to put together is this year's red carpet of masks.
And I don't know. And I heard they're doing it from multiple locations. Who cares? Just skip it.
Yeah. Can't put everybody in one location because of social distancing.
It's so stupid. I filmed the other day, two birds fighting over a Cheeto that I'm sure is better than half the movies that came out this year.
I love it.
But you know what?
I want to see that movie.
I'm going to post it. I'll post it on there. That's what I do. I just walk around and I'm like, oh, look, there's something random. But you know what's cool, though, when I was talking about movies? So we've talked about streaming services a lot and all that. And so I've actually expanded. There were some specials and I got a special for HBO Max. That's the only reason I got it. It was really cheap. It's like 3 months for like $12, you know, something stupid like that. And Warner Brothers signed an exclusive deal with HBO Max to release all the movies the same day they're going into the theaters to put them on HBO Max. So all the new movies, the new King Kong vs. Godzilla, there's a new one with Denzel Washington. That's really good. And Jared Leto. And then there's one I just watched called Judas and the Black Messiah. That was really good. But they come right on HBO Max the same day that they're in the theaters, whichever theaters are open. That has kind of been interesting. And I'm wondering, how is that going to affect the future of Hollywood and awards and viewing? Because I really don't know when we're going to get back to full-blown movie theater operations anytime soon.
Yeah, I mean, if I'm AMC Theaters or I'm Cinemax or whatever, I would be a little upset because, hey, you're taking revenue away from me because people aren't going to come to the theater with you know, whether we do have social distancing and all, when they can just go on the TV, sit back and have their own popcorn and soft drinks right there in their living room and watch it on HBO Max.
it's cheaper. And, you know, Disney Plus has been doing that with their Pixar movies. I think they're still holding off on Marvel because they realize how much revenue there is.
Right.
But I got to be honest with you. They postponed Black Widow for 6 months now, 7 months. Sooner or later, they're just going to say, forget it. Let's put it on Disney Plus. How is that going to affect? Because you can create your theater in your own home. You can buy the greatest sound system, TVs, chairs. I mean, our movie's going to be the same again. I got to be honest with you. I think the movies, we're going to lose a lot of theaters for good.
Yeah, I think you're right. And also the mega theaters, the one with 24 screens. I mean, you know, it just doesn't make any sense.
I just got an alert, not alert, a notification on Facebook or in my thread from South Lyon, where, you know, it's where I went to high school and my parents live in Michigan. And there was a South Lyon movie theater. It was a small town movie theater. They had one screen. I mean, that's it. And they would keep the movies a week, sometimes longer if they were good movies. But it was cheap. Back when I went, it was like $3. And we'd go every Friday. They just officially shut down after, you know, 20-something, 30 years. They just officially shut down. And then I saw that Alamo Draft House is gone. Like, I mean, all those locations are gone. Like, that's...
And they also don't have enough new releases to fill the theaters. So what they're doing is they're showing the retro movies, you know, you know, showing St. Elmo's Fire, showing Breakfast Club, all that kind of stuff. So, you know, and at the same time that they're doing that at the theaters, you also got it streaming on Netflix and on Hulu and Vudu and all those other channels.
I guess people just want the idea. I mean, we do want to get out of our house, you know, and people want to feel normal. So maybe they're like, you know what? I used to go see every year. We would go see Labyrinth. Labyrinth used to be re-released in a local movie theater back home. You know, they do that with Rocky Horror Picture Show and all those. And it was fun to go see the retro movies. It wasn't retro pricing, but it was fun to go see the movies. So I think people just want to get out of the house, but you know, you can only do that for so long. Eventually, you got to figure something out. And I think HBO Max, some of the other services, they're going to capitalize on that. That's billions of dollars, you know?
Sure it is, you know. And then when you do go to the movie, when they used to, you know, charge you $12 for a box of popcorn.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, I don't know about you, and I hate to admit this because, you know, Nobody's going to quote me on this, but I used to go out, get my Patriot Sandwich Company sandwich, and I'd shove it down the sleeve of my jacket and take it in with me. Then I have a nice sandwich while I was watching the movie instead of buying their $20 sandwich.
Look, I'm not ashamed to admit this, and people can quote me on this. I've gone to the dollar store to buy the candy, stuck it in somebody's purse or my pockets and walked into the movie theater and just ate. I got the same bag of Swedish fish there for $1 as opposed to $9 to watch a reboot or a remake of something they've done 15 times.
Yeah. You can go to Kroger, and that Kroger's got all the movie candy. That's 10 boxes for $10, $1 a box, you know, and I go over and I get my Juju Bees and my snow caps and my Ike and Mike and
all the good stuff.
The really good stuff. Yeah.
You know, the other thing too is why was Hollywood's not coming out with anything original either. It's all remakes, reboots, reimagining, sequels. Like, they're remaking The Wizard of Oz.
Again?
Like, why? Yeah. You know, like, why?
Are they going to call it? You know,
The Wizard of Oz.
It's going to be the Wizard of Oz update or something like that.
Yeah, it's probably be modernized, more special effects, which takes away from the classic of how advanced that was back then from going to black and white and color. But then that's like the remakes. Do they ever, I mean, there's not many remakes that work. Like, they remade Charlie's Angels about 4 years ago from the remake of the other Charlie's Angels, which was a remake of a TV show. Then they remade Ghostbusters with all women. That tanked. Then they remade Ocean's 13 with all women. And I'm not being mean to women. All women, which was a remake of the Ocean's 13 with George Clooney. which was a remake of Ocean's 12 or Ocean's 11 with Frank Sinatra. Like,
well, you mentioned The Wizard of Oz. Then they had the black version, which was The Wiz.
Yeah, Michael Jackson. Yeah.
And then wasn't it Oz Revisited?
Yeah.
Another version. Well, you know, and then what they do is well, let's see, we've run the gamut on the movie theaters, so now we're going to put it on the stage and do a stage version of it.
Yeah, and then we're going to do Wicked. We'll do the Wicked version, which is a tale of the witches.
Right.
And it's like, just come up with something original. Just give, look, even if it sucks, just try. Just try.
Yeah. So who are some of your favorite movies?
I'm a big Godfather fan. I love Godfather. Fight Club with Brad Pitt, one of my favorites.
Yeah.
Love it.
That was a good one.
I'm such a big Al Pacino fan. I love Al Pacino. So, you know, not just like Scarface, but like Scent of a Woman is a great movie. He's done The Devil's Advocate with Keanu Reeves. Like,
yes.
Yeah. And then, I mean, I'm a Star Wars guy. I'm a Marvel guy. I love movies, you know. But Denzel Washington has been lately, I'd say the last 5 years. I just love that dude, man. You know, his version of Malcolm X was a phenomenal movie.
Do you find that there are certain actors or actresses that you'll go to see almost any movie that they're in?
Yeah, yeah, guaranteed. Yeah.
I mean, I will go to almost anything that Brad Pitt is in. I'll go to almost anything that Sean Penn is in. Glenn Close, Ellen Burstyn, Judi Dench. Al Pacino.
Good. I love Al Pacino.
Dustin Hoffman, another
one. Yeah, he hasn't done a lot lately. I think he's kind of taken a time out, you know?
And one of my favorite all-time movies, Castaway with Tom Hanks.
I can't say anything. I got nothing to say. If anybody wants to hear what I want to say, check out Catch a Buzz with Brandon.
Yeah, you. I know you threw that one in on an earlier show. You know, I mean, the guy didn't say 12 words in the whole movie, but it ran. What was it? That was almost a 3-hour movie.
It was a 3-hour movie. it was literally Gilligan's Island. They went on a 3-hour tour.
Marianne.
Yeah, no, he had Winston instead, you know, or Wilson, right. or whatever that stupid ball's name was.
And even Winston left him.
Yeah, he even said, you know what, you're bothering me. Like, you're out of hand. There wasn't even any animals on the island. What island was he on?
Yeah, you know what? And they never nominated that dolphin in that movie, the whale that sprayed him to wake him up to let him know there was a ship right next to him.
That movie I have to look because I don't know. Was he nominated for anything in that movie? He probably was. Because Hollywood loves Tom Hanks for some reason.
Yeah, yeah. No, he was nominated for an Academy Award for that.
You know what? There's about 15 people in New York on the subway that talk to a ball that could probably be nominated for that too. Okay. Like, give me a break. Stupid. You know what though? I another guy too, man. I'll watch anything with George Clooney. I love George Clooney, man. He's like he's just a cool dude. He's a good actor, but I'll watch anything with him. Anything.
Yeah, you know, and I think that's what it's kind of come to is that we pick out the actors and actresses that we really like, and we follow them rather than you know where it used to be. Oh, I'll go to any Western. Or I'll go to any spy movie or sci-fi, whatever. It isn't even though, because some of these actors are going from, you know, romantic comedies to sci-fi thrillers and that. So I follow the actor. Another great actor who, I mean, I love the TV series Shameless, but William H. Macy. William H. Macy is one of my all-time favorite actors too.
He plays a lot of weird, quirky roles. And I think it's really cool because you never know what you're going to get with him. You know, he's very unique. The other one I got to mention, Robert Downey Jr. Man, that guy is funny. He's Iron Man. So, I mean, how could you not like him?
Right.
But prior to Iron Man, I mean, he was in, you know, Heart and Souls and that one movie where he played the heroin addict. I forgot what it was called, but he did a great movie with Jamie Foxx, you know, he's phenomenal, and he can cross. He can be action, funny, serious. Great movie.
Wasn't he in U.S. Marshals or something with Tommy Lee Jones?
I don't think he was in that. Was he? Was he?
Robert Downey Jr.
I didn't know that. I should watch it again. Yeah, I like that movie though.
Yeah, it was U.S. Marshals, not because The Fugitive was another one. Ford. Harrison Ford's another one. I follow a lot of his movies.
He's great. Well, how can you go wrong? He was Han Solo in Indiana Jones. I mean, the guy's a beast, you know?
Yeah.
You know what else I would like to watch too? Now I'm going to forget her. She plays Black Widow. She's a good actress. She plays Black Widow and Avengers. Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah.
I just like to watch her. I don't even care where she's at. I just want to watch her.
Charlize Theron.
Yeah. She's gorgeous. Yeah.
She has played a lot of things from, you know, just sexy roles to when she was that death row inmate.
Oh, and Monster.
Oh,
incredible. That was scary. That was scary because she was she was so out of her element. And then they gave her that prosthetic nose and she put on weight, which women in movies typically don't put on weight. Like that's not a thing they do, you know?
Right.
She's amazing. Amazing. Yeah. I like her. I like her a lot.
I guess we should go watch some movies tonight.
Now that's all I want to do. Now Luke and I are going to watch a movie later. It won't be any of the ones we named, but. Yeah.
Oh, well, you know, that's the other thing we should mention to our audience too, is they can catch Luke and Dada's, movie reviews.
Yeah, that's true, guys. We do have a show, Luke and Dada's Movie Review, every week, typically on Sundays. You can watch it on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, all the usual outlets.
I watched it recently, and you really were trying. You were really trying to critique the movie, and Luke just was saying, "I'll give it a thumbs up. Goodbye."
That's it. He's done. Okay.
I'll give it, you know, it's thumbs up, thumbs down, goodbye, I'm ready, let's go eat.
He'll literally look at me when we do it, and he'll be like, I'll be like, you want to do a movie review, buddy? He goes, yeah. So he knows what it is. We set up, and he's ready, and then he's like, yeah, no, bye.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah. Was he a good guy or a bad guy? He was a good guy. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's it. Thumbs up, goodbye.
Yeah, see you later, gotta go. And he'll cut me off, gotta go, I'm out.
Yeah.
I'm like, all right.
So having said that, that's another edition of Trash Talk. And thanks very much. We give it a thumbs up and we got to go.
See you later, guys.